So here we have a Citroen Berlingo electric van. This has got the 22 kilowatt hour battery, and the same vehicle is a Peugeot Partner, of course. So in this video, I'm just going to show you how you replace that 12 volt battery up front. So before you disconnect the battery, you're going to want to unlock the doors and probably leave a door open as well. And then from the passenger side there, release the bonnet catch. And then open up the bonnet. Bonnets stay there, goes in that little hole over there. And on these vans, the 12 volt battery is here inside this plastic box, and they are a little bit awkward. So if you don't know, on these, this end is all the positive terminal. Even though that's a black wire there, that's actually the positive. And the negative terminal on these is actually at the back of the battery, which you can't access. That's why they give you a stud there on the wing if you need to jump start or charge the battery. So what you got to do is disconnect this positive terminal first, and it has this sort of black lever which you pull up, and then you can take that off. And this one's covered in grease. Then you need to remove this cover, and there's little plastic tags either side. This one's actually broken, they always do, but that then comes up, and that is all positive as well. And you'll probably want to remove that nut so you can take this cable off. It's not vital, but I'm going to do it because it just makes it easier to take all of this cabling off, and then you can completely remove that plastic cover out the way completely. So to do that, you want a 13 millimeter socket or spanner, and you can see where these wires route. This wire goes up to there, but also into the fuse box, and then this one is going round here down into the motor stack there. So I'm going to remove both in this case, just so I can get this box completely out the way. And these are being covered with grease, so very easy to drop. And then you can take those off and get rid of this wiring. There's also a plastic thing here which is holding that cable, which you really need to get a little screwdriver in there just to unclip that, so I'll go and get one of those. So yeah, that didn't actually need a screwdriver. You can just pull that to one side, and then you can release that and get rid of all of that wiring there. And this box is sort of sits like this. It's on a slight curve, and what we've got to do from memory is pull it up from the bottom. Oh, look, there's that bit of broken plastic off that, and then you can get it out. And I said it's on a bit of a curve. That's how the feet sit, if that's focusing. So when you go to put it down, you put it down and push it back in like that. So you can get rid of that, and then you can see where your negative terminal is. And by the looks of that, that's either an 8 or 10 millimeter spanner we need for that end. So that's actually 10 millimeters. You don't really need a long extension. I'm being a bit excessive here, but it makes it a lot easier. So slacken that off, and then you should be able to wiggle that one off. But as you can see, this is being covered in grease, so I might leave that with the screwdriver just so I don't get it all over my hands there. And then you can get that one off and out the way. So next, we've got to get that bolt out down there. And actually, this long extension bar is perfect for that. Again, that is 10 millimeters. And then remove that bolt and the bracket without dropping it down. And then you can lift the battery out. So these are an extremely common battery, very common size. They were 50 amp hour, 480 cold cranking amps. That figure doesn't really have much relevance in an electric vehicle. This figure you can almost treat like running time or storage capacity. If you can up that, then all the better. But anyway, I'll put all the details in the video description below as to the size of this battery and all the common replacement batteries, all the common makes and models, to make it easier for you to source your replacement battery. Also in the description below, I'll put the size of that battery tray, so the maximum size of battery you could fit in that tray if you want to put a larger capacity battery in. And that might be particularly useful if you don't do many miles and you suffer with 12 volt batteries going flat. Or another typical scenario is you're using your electric van on a private site and doing lots of very short trips, and the van's not being driven enough to give the chance for that 12 volt battery to charge back up enough, and therefore having a larger capacity battery might help you as well, so they don't drain flat quite so quickly. Also, if you've got a battery charger, it is also worth charging your new 12 volt battery before you put it in the vehicle, because you often find new batteries aren't fully charged. But if you're in a rush and you don't have time, then it's not the end of the world. Because of course, when you put this back in and run the vehicle's going to charge it straight away anyway. So when putting it in, you've got to remember you want the negative terminal at the back. So it wants to go in that way. And then basically put it all back in reverse. So put your clamp bracket down in there and the screw back in. And that's very much easier with a long extension bar. Then you're going to have to put the negative terminal on. So normally you would put the positive on first, but on these batteries you have to do it the wrong way around. So do that up. And then now you've got to put the battery cover back on. These can be a little bit fiddly. You've got to get it so it's also hooked in at the back, so it's quite easy to get the front down but not have the back hooked in like that. So you want to make sure the back isn't rattling and that is locked in place as well, and then give it that little push down and that's locked in. And then we want to put these cables back, leaving it off the battery of course until the end. And then do these up and knit those up tight. I'll sort those wires out afterwards and then give that a good wiggle so it's down as much as you can get it before you lock that into place. I think this isn't quite going down flat. Yeah, I just needed two hands on that. It's a bit awkward doing this sort of job when you're holding a camera and you've only got one hand. And then you can obviously sort those wires out back into that little clamp there. Put your protective cover on over that. And that's all done. And then obviously close the bonnet and then you're good to go, and you can start the vehicle if you need to drive it, or you can put it on charge if you need to charge that traction battery. You've got to remember though, EVs won't charge unless the 12 volt battery is fully charged as well, or at least it's got more than about 9 or 10 volts in it. Okay, that's it for this video. If you found this video useful, please do click that thumbs up button on YouTube. That really does help, and it also helps other people find this channel. Do subscribe if you're not. And if you want to know more about these vehicles, the Citroen Berlingo or the Peugeot Partner Electric van, I'll put a playlist in the video description below where you can watch other videos I've made on these vans. So that's it. I'll see you on the next video.